Now, the next one in this is organizing information. What do you mean by organizing? Now, when I get up in the morning, what is the first thing I do? I wake up and wish my parents, right? That is how you start the day. You wish your parents, then you brush your teeth, fresh yourself, have your milk, and then take your bath and get ready for school, right? So this is a systematic way in which you follow. Now, how about if I get up, first go and bath, then I drink my milk, then I brush my teeth, then I go and wish my parents? It is so odd, right? It doesn't look nice because everything has to be done in a systematic manner, in an orderly form. You have to organize things in a proper way. Then only things will look nice. Okay? Now, when I have my relatives in my house, right? How do we address everyone? Do we call everyone with the same name? No, we cannot call everyone with the same name, no? Otherwise, if I call everyone as mummy or everyone as daddy, then everyone will come running to me. You do not know whom to say or whom to address, right? Even they will not know that whom are you calling. So, we usually divide our relationship and call them by different names. So, how many people are there in your house? Relations. So, who is the first person in your family? It is your parents, right? It is your mother. Then, father, right? So everyone has a mother and a father, right? Everyone, in every family, you have a mother and a father who takes care of us. Apart from that, you have brother or a sister. Your brother or sister would be either elder to you or younger to you. Okay? They are called our siblings. And mother and father are called our parents. Right? So any family will definitely have a parents and a sibling. Right? Apart from these members, who and all are there in your family? Do you have a grandfather? Then, you have a grandmother. Who is a grandfather and a grandmother? Our parents' parents are called as our grandparents. Meaning, for example, your father's mom and your mother's mom and dad are your grandparents. Your father's father or mother's father is your grandfather, and your mother's mother or your father's mother is your grandmother. And we call them grandparents. Do you love your grandparents? Yes. Why? They tell you lot of stories, right? They tell you lot of new things and they get you whatever you want. They take care of you, right? And you enjoy listening lot of stories from your grandparents. Next, who we have? You have uncles, you have aunties, right? Who are uncles and aunts? Your mother's brother or sister, or your father's brother or sister are your uncles and aunts. In other words, you can say your mama, or your chitappa, periyappa, whoever it is, they are your uncles and your atte, your mami, your periyamma, chitti, they are called as your aunties, right? So your mother's sibling, that is brothers and sisters, and your father's brothers and sisters are your uncles and aunts. They are called our relatives. Okay, now the next is your cousins. Who are our cousins? Uncles and aunts' children are our cousins. Okay, the children of your uncles or the children of your aunties are called our cousins, and all these together form a joint family. Okay, so when everyone come together, everyone start living together, we enjoy our family. It is when we celebrate our vacations, we go out and we enjoy in our vacations. At a family which consists of father, mother and the siblings are called as the nuclear family, where every family will definitely have a father, mother and the children. Okay, so are you clear with this concept of relations? Was it very interesting to learn about who and all come in your family or how many people you have in your family? So you all will sit and you will count the number of members who are there in your family. Okay, so did you enjoy the class? Yes. So now we will be moving to our next concept. Hi friends. So now we will be seeing the different modes of transport. What do you mean by transport? Transport is the way how we move from one place to another. Now, for example, I live in Pallavaram. I want to go to T Nagar. So how will I go to T Nagar? Yes, I can either go by walking or I can go by cycle, I can go by scooty, I can go by bus, I can go by train, I can go by car or auto. So the different means in which I can travel from one place to another is called as modes of transport. So you also use various modes of transport in your life, right? So what are the different modes of transport? First is walking. Do you walk in your house? How many of you come by walking to school? Whosever houses nearby the school, they all come by walking. What is the next means of transport? It is bicycle. You all know what is a bicycle? Yes, what is a cycle? Do you enjoy cycling? Yes, you all enjoy cycling, no? How many wheels it has? It has 2 wheels. So when the distance is less, when it is little far away, where through walking you get tired, no? So you can even come by bicycle. It has 2 wheels and it runs on road. It is a road transport. Can you ride a bicycle on water or in air? Can you fly your bicycle? No, right? So it is a road transport. What is the next means of transport? It is your scooter or bike. I suppose everyone has bike or scooty at house, right? Your parents will be using while going to office, or they will drop you school in your bike, right? So the next mean of transport is what? It is a scooty or a bike. Whenever the distance is not very far away, we use the scooter or a bike. How many wheels does it have? It has again 2 wheels and it runs on motor, right? Like cycle, do you have to pedal it? No, you don't have to pedal. You just need to kickstart and it starts going. You need to put a key, you need to kickstart and it will start going, right? What is the next mode of transport? auto rickshaw. Have you seen auto rickshaw? Yes. What is the specialty of auto rickshaw?
It is the only transport which has got three wheels, right?
So you can see a yellow and a black color auto, right? And do you enjoy going in autos?
Yes.
But in auto, you cannot sit when your family is very large. Only 3 to 4 members can sit in an auto and go. There is an auto driver who drives the auto, and again it is a road transport. Fine. So what is the next means of transport? Car, right? Then you have what? Buses. Then you have trucks. Again, all these are road transports, and we use car, bus, trucks and all when we move for a longer journey, right? Usually the buses and the trucks are a heavy transport where they carry lot of loads. Buses carry lot many people. You go to school in buses, right? So when you see in bus, there are many children sitting along with you, right? But can so many children sit in your car or in your bike? No, it is not possible. In buses, you can accommodate many children, right? Similarly, in trucks, they carry lot of loads, right? So buses and trucks are considered as heavy vehicles which carry lot of people and load along with them, okay? What is the next means of transport? Trains. So, train, where do you see moving? Can you see the trains moving on a road? No, right? Trains usually take the rail to move. And it is also the longest transport because trains are so big. There are so many people who travel in train. What are the examples of train? You have electric train. You have the normal train. You have metro train. You have diesel train, right? So where do you see the trains? You can see them in stations, right? So the trains are also the means of transport which travels using the rails, not the road. But it is again a land transport. Okay? What is the next means of transport? Aeroplanes. Do you enjoy aeroplanes? Yes, they fly in the sky, right? So, aeroplane is an air transport. You cannot see the aeroplane going on the road, can you? No, it makes lot of sound and it's a very huge vehicle again. It carries many passengers along with them, okay? So, aeroplane is a air transport and it travels very, very fast, much faster than our land transports, okay? And what are the last source of transport? It is ships and boats, right? So ships, boats, where do you see them? Can you see them on the road? No. Can you see them on the track? Can you see them flying in the sky? No. These transports are seen sailing on the water. So they are the water transports. Okay. So what did we understand today through the means of transports? The means of transports are walking, bicycle, scooter, bike, auto rickshaw, car, buses, trains. All these are what? All these are our road transport. Okay. The trains. Then train is again, where does it travel? They transport through the rails. Okay. And again it is a road transport. Then you have aeroplanes, which is an air transport. And the last one is the ships and boats, which is nothing but our water transport. Okay, so I suppose
you all have understood what are the different modes of transports and what are the different vehicles which we use to move from one place to another. Okay, now we shall have a small exercise, okay, where I will be asking you questions and you need to tell me the answer of the question. So shall we begin? Okay, fine. So now I will be dividing this class into three different groups. Those who are coming by walking will form one group. Those who come by auto will form a group. And those who come by buses will form another group. So now in this class, how many children are there who come by walking to school? Yes. Can you raise your hands? Oh, yes. So I can count 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. So I have 5 children who come by walking. Right? Now, how many children are there who come by bicycle to school? Can you raise your hands? Oh, there are 1 and 2. So 2 children come by bicycle to school. How many children come to school with their parents using bike or scooty? Oh my God, so many of them. So I can see almost 10 children coming through their bikes and scooter with their parents, right? So we have 10 children coming with their parents. How many children come using auto rickshaw? Oh, there are only 3 children. Okay, so 3 children come to school with the auto rickshaw. How many of you come using your school vans and buses? Oh my God, maximum of you come through your school vans. Very good. So how many tires does a van has? Can you tell me? Yes, it has 4 wheels, right? So it is a 4-wheeler. Cars and the vans, they are called as 4-wheelers, right? So how many children do we have? We have 15 children who come in the 4-wheeler. So children, was the class interesting for you all? I hope you enjoyed this class and you all understood the concept of transport and the different means of transport. So, have a great day.